श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। इन मुंडकोपनिषद देयर इज अ मंत्र विच गोज लाइक दिस द्वा सुपर्णा सैजा सखाया समानम वृक्षम परिशश्व जाते तयो अन्यहा पिप्पलम स्वादुमत्ति अनश्नन अन्यहा अभिचाकशी। देर इज अ ट्री एंड ऑन दैट ट्री ऑन अ ब्रांच देर आर टू बर्ड्स द्वा सुपर्णा सैजा सखाया एंड दे आर एग्जैक्टली अलाइक लाइक अवर सेल्व्स एंड अवर रिफ्लेक्शन इन द मिरर। सैजा सखाया बिटवीन द टू देर इज वन बर्ड हु इज परचिंग ऑन दैट ट्री फ्रूट्स एंड व्हेन द फ्रूट इज टेस्टी ही इज हैप्पी हा हा एंड व्हेन द फ्रूट इज बिटर ही इज मिजरेबल ओ हो एंड द अदर बर्ड ही इज नॉट एट ऑल टेस्टिंग ही इज स्टैंडिंग अपार्ट। दिस टू बर्ड्स आर अवर टू हार्ट्स। One heart is the heart which suffers. Other heart is the heart which doesn't suffer. The first heart which suffers is an English suffer. The other heart which doesn't suffer is a Hindi suffer. Those who know Hindi, they can laugh. Those who do not know, suffer. See, friends. Many times we have problems about so many things. One of the problems, this morning I was talking in the morning lecture. There is one lady, she had this problem. Swamiji, I don't get sleep at all. I don't know what to do. I said, go to the doctor. No, they give the sleeping pills and I don't want to take sleeping pills. And then keep awake. No, but they say you should not keep awake days together. It is bad. Then what do I do? I will sleep on your behalf. No. Please help me. Don't make joke of me. I said, okay, listen. When I tell something, I got two conditions. No discussion, no arguments. If you want, I'll talk. There is no. He said, all right. I said, you tell me, how do you sleep? She said, I go to my bed and my Guru Maharaj told me, take the mala in the hand and then I chant the Lord's name so that before I sleep, I should remember him. So I take the mala in the hand and start chanting, Sri Krishna Charanam Mama, Sri Krishna Charanam Mama, Sri Krishna. And it doesn't stop. Whole night it continues and I don't sleep. I don't know what to do. I said, diagnosis is done. Now, the treatment. First, give that mala to me. I took it in my pocket. From today onwards, you are not chanting the Lord's name. Number two. Today you go to bed, sleep on your left side and do this bhavana that you have entered your bloody heart. The heart which pumps blood is a bloody heart. So you enter your bloody heart. And lie down and start playing. Sleep, sleep. And how do we sleep? We don't breathe in sleep very fast. No. In sleep, we breathe very slow. That is how the people, when they snore in the sleep, they are never in a hurry. Have you seen anybody snoring like this thing? Kar, 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 kar. No. They are very steady. No hurry. So, I said, now start playing, sleep, sleep. And she did it. After a few months, she had such a deep sleep. Next day, she got up at 8, 9 o'clock. And in their house, they had celebration. Dadi ma so gayi. See, friends. Now, what exactly has happened? We have got two hearts in our heart, in our personality. One heart is the one which is functional in all the experiences. Other heart is the one which is functional only in selective experiences. For example, we are all awake, I suppose. Nobody is sleeping. In this experience, there is one heart. Then we dream. In that dream, there is another heart. Then we deep sleep. In that deep sleep, there is another heart. These hearts are one per type of experience. See? You must have dreamed sometime. Suppose during the summer days, you have taken a lot of food right up to the nose and very hot weather. So we go to sleep. And when we sleep, we dream. Because of the heat, sleep is not there. Because of the heat, neither we can keep awake. So we keep dreaming. And in that dream we get, I am terribly hungry and I have to go and eat somewhere. Now who is getting that hunger? This fellow overate and slept, and yet the hunger is still there. So there are two personalities. Mr. Waker is different from Mr. Dreamer. Mr. Dreamer and Waker, they are different from Mr. Deep Sleeper. And all three of them have their individual hearts. Three friends. And how they operate? When the heart is functioning from the right eye, in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, this thought comes. When the heart is functioning from the right eye, it is a waking experience for Mr. Waker. It is said, I don't know, I am not a medical professional, I am only a patient. Today, Dr. Henry brought me here, but unfortunately, I disappointed him. They tried to find out something wrong with my heart, but it's bloody running fast. So, the heart in the waking state functions through the right eye, Dakshinaksha. In the dream, the same heart functions from the throat. And in the deep sleep, the same heart functions from the bloody heart. So these three personalities, waker, dreamer and deep sleeper, they have got three different hearts and their functioning loci are different. One is the right eye, second is the throat, third is this bloody heart. Now be attentive. The waker and his life has nothing to do with the dreamer and his life. The deep sleeper has nothing to do with the waker and the dreamer. So thus, there are three hearts for three personalities that we carry as a burden on ourselves. But there is one more heart, the second type of heart, which is common. That heart is common for the waker, for the dreamer and for the deep sleeper. That heart is called as the spiritual heart and other heart is called as the material heart. Material heart is taken care of by you people. The spiritual heart is taken care of by we people. Now what is the spiritual heart? The bloody heart, we know where it is. Now the spiritual heart, according to Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, is the center of our chest. This is called where, you know, because you are medical people, you know. The floating ribs where they unite in the sternum, that is the point where there is the spiritual heart. And how this heart becomes functional? When a child is born and if the child doesn't cry, the parents start crying. So what do? We take the child and do Urdhva Moola Madashakam Ashwattam Pravarambhyam. It is held upside down and cold water is splashed and it creates a kind of spasm. And this heart, the real heart, the spiritual heart becomes activated. And when the spiritual heart becomes activated, then in the, before the breathing begins, the diaphragm is in a dome shape. concavity in the abdominal side, convexity in the thoracic side. And when this spiritual heart becomes activated, as a result, diaphragm becomes flat. Then there is a vacuum created in the chest or the thorax. And then there is a suction of air. So breathing in is a passive process. It is not an active process. And till such time, this throb of consciousness is continued. Till then, breathing continues. This is the spiritual heart, and this is what makes all the difference in our life. As it is required, we have to take care of our bloody heart. Again and again check whether there are some deposits, whether plumbing is required. They are not plumbing only, remove this and fix this and join it nowhere. See? So as we have to take care of our physical heart, we also have to take care of our spiritual heart. Taking care of physical heart, there is nothing more that I can tell you. I can talk to you on taking care of the spiritual heart. First of all, we have to recognize the presence of the spiritual heart. When we talk to somebody, I told you. So how do we refer to this I told you? Do we say I told you? No, we don't have the feeling that I am here. Do we say I told you? We don't have the feeling that I am in the, you know, patella. Then we say I told you. This feeling of I, the sense of I, is in the spiritual heart. And second thing, this spiritual heart is also reflected in our palm. Our pure self is covered by 5 layers. See? Like, you know, I am covered by first shawl, then the lungi, etc. In the same manner, our being is covered by 5 layers. The external layer that we all see each other is the gross body called as the annamaya kosha, the modification of the food. The food eaten by the parents gets converted into seeds, the seeds unite and produce a zygote, therefore it's called as a, children are called as kids, because the first is zygote, goat becomes the kid afterwards. So the kid is slowly growing inside the woman, her mother's womb. She goes on sucking the blood of the mother, after comes out, sucks the milk, then destroys the food, and one day becomes the food for others. This is how Annamaya Kosha is made out of food, maintained in food, ultimately becomes food for somebody. This is the external covering. In this, inside, there is a layer called as the Pranamaya Kosha, because of which the life is maintained. And this Pranamaya Kosha is not under our control. Breathing is not done. Breathing happens. See, friends, Pranayama we can do. Breathing we cannot do. Breathing is happening. And till such time the breathing continues, the life is maintained in the body. This is the second layer. The third layer is the mind layer. So like for any one of us, our house is a gross body, then the power supply is the Pranamaya Kosha, then the means of communication with the world is the mind. But the question comes, whose body, whose prana, whose mind? Of course, my body, my prana, my mind. The sense of ownership is indicated by the third layer called as the Vijnanamaya Kosha. So, 4 of them now, so far. Small finger is Annamaya Kosha, gross body. This ring finger is Pranamaya Kosha. Therefore, after marriage, the prana becomes disturbed. Then the third is the Manomaya Kosha, the middle finger which is biggest. And the fourth is Vijnanamaya Kosha, a sense of I that is born. Now be attentive. When we say, I told you, this I, which is expressing through this tarjani, comes directly here. I. This sense of I, where it is located, is our spiritual heart. We never say, if you don't listen to me, I am going to kill you. With these small fingers, you cannot say. If you say like this, it's okay, go and come back. Because the sense of I is only in this finger. Technically, it's called as tarjani. Tarjani means threatening. I only threatens you. So this I has to be recognized. See, friends. Recognition of this I is working on the spiritual heart. The bloody heart can be taken care of by the external gross means. See? But the subtle heart, the spiritual heart, has to be taken care of by the spiritual means. It cannot do anything else. And it is here we start working on the heart. This heart is mentioned different ways with different references. Commonly it is called as the mind. So, as is our mind, so is our personality. If our mind is confused, we are confused. If the mind is angry, we are angry. If there is a misery in the mind, we are miserable. If there is a joy in the mind, we are happy. Thus, we get identified with this spiritual heart called as the mind, and accordingly we become good or bad, happy or miserable. And thus, our life is constantly buffeted by the ups and downs of this spiritual heart. And therefore, friends, the highest spiritual practice is working on your mind. Normally, we work by the mind. In your material world, we work by the mind only. We take the observations and yes, this is right, that is wrong, correct it, working by the mind. But if the mind is disturbed, then we take some tablets, pills or pillow and quieten the mind. We are not working on the mind. We are working by the mind. Taking care of the spiritual heart is start working on the mind. Now one example I'll tell you, how do we work on the mind and how do we simply work by the mind. Now those of you who are doing some spiritual practices, we are told by our elders, you should think of God. So how do we think? In every religion, they give one mala, rosary, and keep on chanting. Whatever religion you take. So we take the mala in the hand, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate. And then you have got shortage of time and you have to complete that whole mala. Then you go into the SMS of the mantra. Jai Shri Krishna becomes JSK. This is working by the mind. So we hurry up and somehow finish it. And such people are never at peace with themselves. Always agitated, disturbed, because they have never taken care of mind. Friends, we all take care of everything around in our life. Our house should be in a good locality. There should be good color scheme inside the house. There should be good furniture. There should be proper decorations. Everything we take care. Clothing we take care. It should be matching. The red salwar, red kameez, red shoes, red bag, and red car, and red.com, and Red Bull is coming. Matching, how much? But what we have taken care of till date about the quality of our mind. Friends, everything we have to learn, this we know, Even making a chapati, these girls have to learn. Initially, for the first time, when they make the chapati, first chapati becomes like a South Island of New Zealand. Mummy, mummy, why this chapati is becoming like this? Then the mummy did not this way, you have to do this way. And with great difficulty, that South Island becomes Australia, and Australia becomes India, and somehow, after 5-10 years, it becomes a round globe. That's such a simple thing we have to learn. But when it comes to thinking, what we have done to learn how to think. See, friends, because there are thoughts in our mind, we cannot be called as thinkers. See, friends, because there are trees, it cannot be called as a garden. It could be a jungle. Both the places, garden and jungle, there are only trees. But the basic difference is, in jungle, the trees have no control over growth. Any tree can grow anywhere, all wild animals around. So when we go to jungle or forest, we are afraid. What is a garden? Every tree is selected, planted, curled, pruned, then weeding is done, then manuring is done, the irrigation is done, beautifully maintained. So when we go to the garden, we are so happy. In the same manner, when we go inside our mind, we are so frustrated. So we go, "Are Gupta ji, kya ho raha hai?" So Gupta ji asks, "How come Varma ji you have come?" "No yaar, main akela bore ho raha tha. I was getting bored by myself." If you get bored of somebody, you can understand. But when we get bored of ourselves, how solid bored we must be. It is something like, one patient went to the doctor and said, "Doctor Saab, I have got a problem that when I sleep, I snore so loudly that because of my snoring, my sleep gets disturbed. What do I do?" So the doctor said, "Go and sleep in the other room." When a person gets disturbed and disgusted and bored of his own presence, what a disgusting existence that is. Then what we do? We start seeking company. See, Facebook. Facebook is nothing. All those disgusted, frustrated, outdated, unwanted creatures, they come together on the Facebook. Where is the time to go to the Facebook? Useless. The other day, somebody sent me a very beautiful SMS. One Sardarji was introducing his family. "This is my wife, Google Kaur." Google Kaur? Yes. You ask her one thing, she tells 10 things. Google doesn't give one reply, gives 100 options, 10 things. Then, "This is my son. His name is Facebook Singh. Every small little thing happens in the house, he has to tell the whole world." Facebook Singh. "And this is my daughter. She is Twitter cop. Everybody follows her." The question is, "Then who are you?" "Oh, I am Orkut Singh. Nobody comes to me." We have taken care of everything in life, but never taken care of our mind. See, friends. Therefore, we have to start working on the mind. Working by the mind is not enough. See. And when we start working on the mind, we are now taking care of the second heart, which is more important than the first heart. The first heart's functioning is controlled and dependent on the second heart, the spiritual heart. If you see the work output by the great masters in this world, the amount of recorded work by Vivekananda is so much that even if we simply read it, our whole life is not enough. And how many years he lived? Only up to the age of hardly 39. But within that 15-20 years of his age, now even less than 15 years, the amount of output, where from it comes? Because he was functioning by the spiritual heart and not by the bloody heart. This bloody heart's condition is totally governed and controlled by the spiritual heart. If your spiritual heart is perfect, you may work day and night, 24/7. Yet you are relaxed. See? And therefore, it is our bounden duty to take care of this spiritual heart. And taking care of the spiritual heart means working on the mind, first of all. When we want to work on the mind, how do we begin? See, working on the mind, there are many techniques. I'll give one or two of them. Simple techniques. Anybody can try. And I guarantee you, it will change your whole life. Without any doubt. 100% guarantee. Technique number one. Stop talking to yourself. Stop. Don't have to do anything. I am not giving a mala in your hand. No, show, no, show, no, show, no, show. No. Simple. Stop talking to yourself. And before you talk to others, ask a question. Is it necessary to talk? You will get an answer. Not at all. Keep mouth shut. See, friends. Then you are working on the mind. When we talk to ourselves, we talk about future. And what is the future? The non-existing problems are sorted out. See? This is how we keep on doing all the time. Try to go there. Now what is happening? Talking to yourself. And we call ourselves in that case, when we talk to ourselves and others don't hear, then we call, I am little sentimental. So when we talk to ourselves, others don't listen, we become sentimental. When we talk to ourselves and others also listen, we call him as mental. So like we have got a centimeter becomes a meter ultimately, in the same manner, sentimental becomes a mental ultimately. See, friends, most of you are young here. You will not appreciate this from your experience. But look at the oldies in your house. They suffer the most. The reason is, they don't have desire about the worldly things. Whatever they have to earn, they have earned. Whatever they have to enjoy, they have enjoyed. Now in the old age, all their faculties are worn out. There are no desires for worldly indulgence. But their problem is, Swamiji, man ko shanti nahi. Kya kare? Ghar ka naam rakh do, Om Shanti. See, friends, we suffer maximum only because of ourselves, not because of others. The reason is, we have never worked on the spiritual heart. Work on it. Give it a try. See? Don't go in the future unnecessarily. I don't know what is going to happen. Like many people ask this question. I don't know what is going to happen. If you don't know, relax. If you don't prepare. Worry is not a solution. But like, you know, addiction we have got for different drugs, etc. Similarly, we get addicted to worry. In one house, this is Bangalore, isn't it? Bangalore only. There used to be my friend in Indira Nagar. He now shifted to Noida near Delhi, a retired brigadier. So he retired brigadier means that time he was about 65 or so. And he had his mother. And his mother was about 92 not out. So he told me, "Swamiji, please stay with my mother. She's all the time worried, worried, worried. Worried about those things for what she does not, she doesn't require to worry. But she worries all the time. Uska kya ho gaya? Uski shaadi hui ki nahi? Why do you worry? Relax." So she worries. "Please tell her not to worry." So I went to her. I said, "Mama, there is a complaint against you. You worry all the time for no reason." She became angry with me. "You also come and tell me the same thing. Don't worry. Then what do I do?" See, she is so true. It is a habit of worrying, friends. We become habitual. Because during our formative life, we have not taken care of this principle. Stop talking to yourself. Many times people observe moan. What is their technique of moan? They will be taking a paper and pencil, a diary in their hand. They will not talk with the mouth, but they will write down, "Get me a cup of tea." And then the fellow gets a cup of tea. "Chini to dali le." "Aur thoda doodh le." Why don't you talk straight away with your mouth? See, friends, mauna is not keeping silent by your mouth. Mauna is keeping silent by your mind. If you can mind your mind, you have learned how to control the spiritual heart. See, friends, this is one technique. Give it a try. Wherever you are, see that. Again, did you slip into that mode of talking to yourself? When I move around the world, many airports, you have to wait for 2 hours, 4 hours. So I sit down. So one person asked me, "Swamiji, don't you get bored sitting there till the next flight comes?" I said, "Why should I get bored? There is a live cartoon show." Because most of the people are traveling alone. So they keep on talking. "Should I take it for my daughter?" "No, she will not like it." "Son?" "Oh, he is gone." "He is talking to whom?" "To himself." Non-stop. See, friends, from now onward, observe this phenomena in yourself. Don't talk. Now we will do this experiment right away. For next 60 seconds. Do not talk to yourself. Over. If we can't keep our mind shut for 1 minute, what can we achieve in life? We have to work on our mind. Work. Give it a try. You may fail 100 times, never mind. 101st time you will succeed. This is working on mind. And when you are busy working on your mind, you have no time to worry about the world. See? Why the world is like that? Have you created? No. Why you worry? See? Take care of yourself. See, we are not responsible for all that is happening in the life. Many people have got this problem about corruption. How many? What is your opinion about corruption? Corruption? If I get chance, I will also do. Don't get carried away. This is not our field. Limit yourself in the field of operation where you are having authority. Where you don't have authority, don't get into it. See, this I learned from a taxi driver. Keep this learning process alive. You will be very happy throughout life. Once we were going somewhere and my friend told Swamiji that taxi fellow's driver is open. Something may happen. I'll take it parallel. You tell him that, hey, darwaja khula hai, band karo. So he took it and I had to listen. So he did the glass down. He says, Swamiji, bolo usko. I said, hey, tumhara darwaja khula hai, band karo. He said, who asked you? Take care of yourself. Very true. Is it not true? So my friend says, see how rubbish he is. He is not rubbish, he is my guru. What business we have got to poke our life into others' life? Keep away. But we are Indians. You know the basic qualities of Indians? For Indians, every time is a tea time. Any time, anywhere you go. Chai piyenge, are 2 o'clock at night. Second thing, every Indian can take decision for anybody on any issue. In our houses, we have got, you know, these vigilance officers. Oldies, they have nothing to do. So all the time, watching who has come, who has gone. And then that Dadima tells to her daughter-in-law, Bahu, I think we should get our Kalpana married. Take a decision. Why? She is these days looking outside the window. There is something wrong there. And then investigation continues. And the only solution is for all the diseases, problems of life, get married. Over. Book for life. See? Decision. We don't have to take decision for others. See? The whole Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna told Arjun. After that, he said, hey Arjun, I have told you whatever has to be told. Now, yad vimrsha tad asheshena yathechasi tatha guru. Now you decide what you have to do. Never take decisions for others. But we are Indians. We have to take decisions. Then Indians become good advisors. What others should do, we can tell perfectly. What we have to do, we are gone. Do your job and relax. This is how our mind is not under control. So before we talk to others, the second technique, before we talk, ask this question, is it necessary to talk? See, you will get a really not necessary. He never asked me. Did I ask you? No. But then why do you tell? Oh, I'm so sorry. See? The net result will be, now you started working on your mind. And when you just start working on your mind, be attentive. Your mind will be an asset to you, not a liability. Presently, our mind is a liability for us. It is not an asset. So instead, we working through the mind is working through us and make us dance. Like, you know, the drama you must have seen on the roadside. That monkey charmer, he has got two monkeys and both of them are tied with a, you know, small chain, and then he start dum 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 dum, and people in India, we are never short of time, so people all around come, you know, and thereafter he moves that monkey with a ball in the hand and collects some money and he says, Gangaram, Gangaram. Again another again some money. Gangaram, Rupmati se shadi karoge. So Gangaram is very happy. Yes, 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 yes. Again some money collected. Then Gangaram is tied down. Then the other monkey, she is taken. She has got a nice frock and bow and everything, you know, lipstick and everything. And then again, she, Rupmati, Rupmati, again Gumam. Rupmati, Rupmati, Gangaram se shadi karoge? Thu, thu, thu. Like this, the charmer is making the monkeys dance. Our mind is making us dance. Misery is come. I am most miserable. Swamiji, why I have to get the wife like this? Start crying. Don't have self-pity on yourself. As we should not have pity on others, don't have pity on yourself. Watch these modifications of the mind. And this thing comes only because we are not working on the mind. Having desire, anger, greed, pity, etc. This is working by the mind. Work on the mind. And when you are busy working on the mind, then you will see life is most beautiful. Then your vision will change. It is something like, you know, when you are standing below the tree, your radius of observation is limited. And when you go and sit on the top of the tree, your radius observation is widened, is it not? We are at present sitting under the tree called as the body. Rise above. From the body, come to the prana. From the prana, come to the mind. From the mind, come to the conscious reality, which is the spiritual heart. And those whose spiritual heart is awakened, their perception is of a different dimension than what we see in this world. Once I was sitting on the top of a tree without the tail. And below the tree, one old villager was standing. Evening time, frustrated, no transport. So he started. Good. Can you hear in darkness? I am happy that you can hear in darkness. So, when he was crying, oh God, said somebody, how will I go to my village? It is so difficult. And I was sitting on the top. From above, I made Akashvani. My dear child, don't worry. A bullock cart will come with a black and a brown bullock. And there will be a person sitting with a green turban. It will be loaded with grass. Ask him for a lift, you can go your house. And exactly after 1 hour, a bullock cart comes, he goes home. Do you think he will keep quiet? You know, I was there and from where, nowhere the sound came and I came here. Next day, the whole village come, dung, 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 dung. Some Mahatma is sitting on the top. They pulled me down. Om Jai Jagadish Hare. Now exactly what has happened? What was the future tense for the man below the tree was the present tense for a man on the top of the tree, is it not? Because the man below the tree could see in a radius of only, let us say, 1 kilometer, and the man on the top of the tree could see in a radius of 10 kilometers. Think. In the same manner, when we are living as the body, for the body, on everybody, the radius of our perception is limited only to I and my, me and my wife, my children, me and my wife. There is much more in this world than this wretched little small family. See friends, unless we break open this small little cocoon existence, The spiritual heart will not open. And when the spiritual heart has to be opened, we have to start climbing from the bottom of the tree, go to the top of the tree. And what is the bottom of the tree? Is the body identification. Rise above, come to the prana. Become dynamic, unselfish activity. Come to the mind, discipline and control the mind, educate the mind. With these three instruments at your disposal, then sky is the limit for evolution. Then we are working on the spiritual heart. Spiritual practice is not taking the container, Om Jai Jagadish, could nothing be there. God told me, because he doesn't listen. He has got better things to do. Work on the mind. And when you just start working on the mind, the net result will be, you will be at peace with yourself. A person who is at peace with himself, he alone can be at peace with the whole world. And a person who is frustrated, disgusted, he is never happy with the world. See? Take an example. God created this world for a time pass and fun. There is no other purpose. He told me. So, when you have to have fun, it cannot be a serious affair. Fun is fun. So, what he did? They say that the marriages are fixed in the heavens. But this is incomplete statement. The complete statement is, marriages are fixed in the heaven, so also the lightning and thunder. So to make the lightning and thunder in the marriages, what Bhagwan does, he brings cathode and anode together. The husband and wife, they have got exactly opposite nature. If the wife is happy-go-lucky, the husband is perfectionist. And as a result, husband suffers also perfectly because he is perfectionist. And the wife is happy-go-lucky. It's okay, we'll do it tomorrow. Now let us watch a movie. Saas Bahu. She's enjoying life. And his husband Maharaj, he's all the time worried about the cleanliness, discipline. Oh. And they hold the frustrated and they go to bed. This Mahamaya, she touches the bed and starts snoring. In no time she sleeps. And this perfectionist doesn't get sleep. Then, why do you sleep? Then what do I do? I'm not getting the sleep. See friends, a person who doesn't get sleep, if we see the partner is sleeping, he becomes more angry. In the same manner, if you are not at peace and if somebody is happy, you become more angry. If you are at peace with yourself, you are at peace with the whole world. See friends, this is working on our second heart. And as you start climbing from the bottom of the tree through the body, prana, mind, come to the intellect, to Mr. I. And when you come to this Mr. I, now start working on who is this I? Is he the bloody I or the spiritual I? Then we will come to know, I inside is not one. It's a crowd inside. Husband, wife, brother, father, mother, sister, mother-in-law, father-in-law, daughter-in-law, all in-laws, outlaws, it's a big crowd inside. And then, which I am? See? Whether I am a mother or father or brother or sister or husband, who are they? By birth, we are nobody's husband, isn't it? Remaining without marriage as a bachelor is our natural condition. Getting married is unnatural condition. Whenever you are in unnatural condition, you cannot be happy. And then we become husband. And after becoming husband, we want to be happy. It is impossible. Then what is to be done? Take the husbandhood lightly. Don't take it seriously. And thus work on yourself. Who is this I? Then we come to know this I, they are not one, many. And we have to play all the roles. Play every role perfectly. And the moment the role is over, discard the costume and come back to yourself. See, friends. But what happens? We carry the burden of one role into another role. One man had a fight with his wife, and with that fight mode, he left home for the office. Very frustrated with the wife. I don't know. Came to the office. And he had his secretary. So, secretary and he, they had very good relation, good rapport. So, the secretary told, just wrote a small slip. Sir, I have to take my wife for medical checkup. Therefore, I want to take half day casually. I'll come after the lunch break. Thanking you in anticipation. Normally, even that is not required. That day, when he saw the application, my wife has to be taken for medical checkup, he got wild. Nothing happens to the wife. No. Are you a Rashtrapati or what? Nothing happens to the wife. How do you know? Because when he came to the office, he did not leave the husband at home. He brought the husband in the office, and the moment he read the word wife, the husband was invoked and he became angry. See, friends, play your role perfectly, whatever you have to do. And the moment it is over, relax, relax, relax. See, friends, when this is done, the basic principle of your life will be relax. Do that and relax. Do that and relax. Slowly, slowly, whatever you are doing, even while doing, you will be in a relaxed mode. Never tense. Once there was a conference in Detroit, we were invited. And there was one professor, Rao, from Oxford. He also came. And there was some function kind of thing. And after my lecture was over, our lecture is freestyle. So my lecture was over. Then the organizer called. Now we request Mr. Rao to come and deliver the lecture. Excuse me, I am not Mr. Rao. I am Dr. Rao. Okay, we are very sorry. Dr. Rao. Doctor is not a Mr. He is only Dr. Then he came and he saw, he had half a dozen books, bookmark and you know, dog-eared and everything, kept put it on the podium. And then he saw this Babaji started firing freehand, so he started. After 10 minutes he said, I am extremely sorry gentlemen, I don't know what I am talking, let me read my lecture. And he read his lecture, which was out of place, not required. And after all that was over, then frustration. This audience is not live. Because you spoke what is not required. Keep yourself always free. Never have preconceived notions about anything. Like if you are doctors, when one patient comes, you diagnose him having constipation, prescribe, he goes away. When the patient goes, along with him, the disease also goes. Suppose the constipation remains with the doctor. The second patient comes and he is having dysentery. But the constipation has infected the doctor. So, the differential diagnosis cannot be perfect. So, the second patient will be also given the same constipation medicine to the dysentery fellow. All calamity. Exactly this is what happens in life. Don't mix issues in life. One issue, separate it out. And that can be done only when we play our role perfect. Whatever role we have to play, play your perfect. For example, now. We are here for this thinking process. Now at this moment, we are here for this purpose. So do this sincerely. You are in meditation. The purpose for what we have come, if that is not done during that period, can we do it later afterwards? We cannot do it. Therefore, all the happiness, all the joy, all the spiritual practice happens only now or never. Now the last thing about the spiritual heart is, mind cannot survive unless it goes in the past or it goes in the future. Mind cannot survive. So when we talk to other people about our past, what do we talk? We talk all the time about to other people about our past. Jaane kahan gaye wo din. Who cares? But oldies don't understand. Whenever they are among the youngsters, they will be bringing. No, jab hum bacche the, who cares yaar, tum bacche the. But these oldies have no future, only the past. And therefore, they are never able to live in the present. Or, they will be constantly projecting the future. Don't know what is going to happen to India if you don't know, relax. Thus, keep yourself in the utter present. And see, living in the present, do we have any option? We cannot live yesterday. We cannot live tomorrow. We have to live today. See, if we have to live today, living today is easier than living yesterday or living tomorrow. But what we do? All the time, we are trying to bring the yesterday into today and trying to push the today into tomorrow, and both the principles will fail. And as a result, the beauty of the present is lost. See friends, when we learn to remain in the utter present 24/7, you have awakened your second heart, the spiritual heart. Such masters become the storehouse of infinite potentiality. See? They are able to motivate, inspire millions around them. See? Working on unhealthy heart will cure that one unhealthy heart. But the real working is working on this healthy heart, which is a problem for the society, is a real challenge. See? All the bad elements in the society, terrorism, etc. Can you imagine a terrorist came with a gun in the hand and he said, hey, come on, hold my gun, I have got a back pain. They are all healthy. Physically they are healthy, but mentally they are perverted. So mental perversion is a more serious challenge and disease than the physical heart problem. And therefore, we have to invoke the spiritual heart in our own life. And when we thus invoke the spiritual heart, the quality of our life changes. And the quality of our life is like a magnet. Wherever the magnet is put, it collects dozens of iron files with it. In the same manner, we become most wanted personality in the world. Everybody wants us. In the old days, one of the biggest suffering old people have, nobody wants them. They are lonely in the crowd because they are not living in the present. Therefore, present living is awakening the spiritual heart. Present day, our condition is like a man with two wives. One wife is pulling in this direction, other is pulling in this direction. And they are going in round and round. Like a churning rod, he is being churned. In the same manner, our mind is either pulled in the past or pulled in the future. As a result, in the present, there is no charm to live. See friends, therefore, Working on the second heart, the spiritual heart, is the greatest asset. And when we have worked on the spiritual heart, what happens is we remain inspired. Inspiration is a catalytic agent which can be added to every role that we play. And a catalytic agent is the one which speeds up the process, but which doesn't get sorted out. It remains untouched. Exactly the same way. Inspiration add to any role that you play. Ordinary husband, inspired husband. Ordinary doctor, inspired doctor. Ordinary patient, inspired patient. Ordinary student, inspired student. Ordinary teacher, inspired teacher. Inspiration goes with every role that we play. And whenever inspiration is the foundation of our expression, the best in us surfaces without efforts. In that case, we outwit our own performance every now and then. Then life doesn't become a mundane burden that we carry. And all the secret is awakening this spiritual heart. So let us work on this spiritual heart along with the other muscular heart. And thus make our life a perfect balance between the material prosperity and the spiritual eminence in this very life. Then the life is fulfilled. When the life is fulfilled, there are no regrets of wrong commissions. There are no regrets of right permissions. Life is at peace. Friends, this is not theoretical. It is possible for every one of us. It is not meant for a chosen few. It is meant for everyone. Let us give it a try and be happy. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Thank you.